In this session, it's entitled, What Should Be the Clinical Targets of Successful Iron Chelation Therapy in MDS? And I think this is really an excellent question because I do think that we don't really understand for sure what the targets should be and whether that should be variable between subtypes of MDS. But during this talk, I'm going to review the measurements of iron overload that we have access to now and in the future, talk about why address iron overload in MDS, some of the clinical endpoints that have been documented to be impacted by iron overload, some of the mechanisms of how iron overload confers toxicity to the cells and organs, the relevant targets of iron reduction in MDS, and stop with some summary and conclusions and also future directions. So the clinical targets that we have right now consist of serum ferritin level, which is very widely used and obviously the most convenient measure in clinical practice. We do have imaging of organs by techniques such as T2 star MRI. We also have measures of oxidative stress, such as non-transferrin bound iron and labeled plasma iron. And interestingly, those are elevated at a high transferrin saturation. And I'm going to be discussing some new data from the Canadian MDS registry looking at transferrin saturation and how that is related to clinical outcomes. I'm also going to propose some criteria for the severity of iron overload in MDS and also some criteria for documenting where we're at with iron reduction in any particular patient. So I do look forward to this session and to the discussion that ensues and hope you will be able to attend.